out of your schedule to sit around and talk about it, guys tend to dive on you.
Another man may be counting stars at this point.
He can't count. In his second year as a wrestler, he is a current RGL champion, and the crowd here in Chapel Hill loves he and the television champion here tonight.
Only the second man in the history of the Rising Generation League to fight all the way through the tournament and retain the championship.
Absolutely, he did that just this past December, and he did so against none other than the man in the corner right now, Ethan Alexander Sharp.
Absolutely. Sharp has been a perennial rival of Adler, and now it would appear that Sharp's minion, so to speak, number man, joining in.
Oh, nice reversal.
You run into that a lot of times, C-Bear. You can attest to it. You know, guys that have wrestled with each other, they've trained together, and then as they grow up in the sport, you know, they kind of become professional rivals. They kind of get attached to somebody that, careers are forever linked to that person.
Right, a good example right here in house is our heavyweight champion Trevor Lee and none other than Andrew Everett.
Absolutely.
Their destinies are probably intertwined till the day they retire.
There's been quite a few over the years, Eric Royal and Ray Kandrak, who are now the Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champion.
Number man. Well, I very unwisely just got right back up.
Does not seem like a partnership in the truest sense of the word. It certainly seems more like a employee-employer relationship.
Absolutely. Ethan Sharp even talked about, we got to cover, he said he was going to give Number Man a raise last week.
There you go.
To $1 a match.
That's pretty good.
He's done better than a lot of guys.
More than a lot of those Wentworth shows. Number Man reverses. Adler hits the buckle.
Hey, he took that one hard. And Number Man, he talks a lot.
Yes, he does. Gorgeous top body. Clever. Two. Only got two.
Hey, he'll get up on a guy, and then he'll sit there and talk about it for a good 15 seconds. He gets cut off quite a bit.
Yeah, you got two champions in there. That's not the way you want to do things. You want to stay on top of that champion. Whoa! Oh! Thought he was going to soar right between the ropes. Clever. Two.
They're about to send him into one of these hoops over here on the other side of the building.
That would have been 3 points.
3 points, hard in the paint, brother.
Two fingers in the eyes.
Ah! That man's getting his ass beat right now.
Cecil!
He is. This happens every match. State rolling here to play the Tar Heels right now. They're just getting mud rushed.
This crowd likes the body-to-body contact. They like hearing it and feeling it. Woo!
Number man don't like it too much. Oh, poor Number man.
Number two! He survived.
Throat?
I believe it was.
You can never count out the Number Man.
The strike to the throat. Questionable at best. And in comes the master in this master man servant relationship, Ethan Alexander Sharp. C-Bear, I know you know all about those.
I was about to make a whole lot of comparisons that'd probably get me run out of this building on a rail.
Probably.
So I'll just keep it to myself.
Sharp. Like him or not, and quite frankly, no one does.
No.
Sharp may be the most improved wrestler on the roster. Bell to bell, this guy has worked hard, been closely mentored by Roy Wilkins, the former Mid-Atlantic heavyweight champion. Drop toe hold, Adler.
Ooh. best matches of the year against Trevor Lee. Yeah. So he's got a little momentum, even in defeat.
Yeah, undeniably the biggest test of his young career, even tonight. Just walking around, looking at him in the eyes, you can tell he has so much more confidence now after hanging for 40-some minutes with the Mid-Atlantic champion, the best in the game right now. Adler holds on.
But you can't look past a guy like Number Man or Ethan Sharp, as you can see.
Using the numbers to their advantage.
He had about four digits in the hair of Jesse Adler.
Coming in back in the ring.
Referee didn't see any of it.
Again on the hair. These two have been to Battlecade and back against each other. Sharp won the first round, what, about 16 months ago now?
About a year and a half.
Adler won the second round, eliminated Sharp from the RGL tournament, went on to beat Darius Lockhart in the finals. But again, these two, it would seem, might be locked together forever. You see that a lot with training partners, guys that start out the same time, they have their first match about the same time. They enter the Rising Generation League tournament about the same time. Cliff Garrett trying to get Adler back to his feet here. Of course, the Rising Generation League Championship for wrestlers with 3 years of professional experience or less. Both these men in the ring right now are in their last year of eligibility.
Right, so come December, Adler will relinquish the title for the final time, if I'm not mistaken.
We will be scouting prospects for this year's Rising Generation League tournament here in the coming months.
A lot of young prospects on the horizon, some guys that Coach Gemini's brought in. We saw Cameron Carter.
Leapfrog, new kick. A little bit of sass there from Ethan Sharp.
It's a little bit of a unusual sass from Ethan Sharp. Usually a lot more reserved.
Number Man slugging away.
Is Number Man RGL eligible?
You know, it's tough to say. He's kind of like Doctor Who. He regenerates every so often. I guess this incarnation of Number Man would be RGL eligible.
So the David Tennant version of Number Man, he could compete.
Now let Number Man have it.
Number Man's not used to this kind of treatment. Like that.
Yeah, both these men have been associated with the coach. Of course, the Moneyball group that has been a thorn in the side of Snooty Fox for all these weeks.
It all comes to a head tonight.
Number Man in control of the Rising Generation League champion. And they're trying to fight to his feet.
And another handful of hair, the referee warning him at least.
These two had a great Rising Generation League championship matchup.
Well, it's Red Zone. telegraphed that enziguri in that, and Ethan Sharp saw it coming.
You touched on that tremendous 40-plus minute match against Trevor Lee a few weeks back. I almost wonder how much perhaps that match took out of Jesse Adler. Numberman and Sharp have been able to isolate him for several minutes here. You know, this is a quiet young man. He could be nursing an injury we don't even know about, C-Baron.
You're absolutely right. And people don't realize it takes weeks to get over a match like that.
It's Crowd in Chapel Hill on their feet for the Rising Generation League champion.
He's got to fall back.
Adler has got to break free. 540 degree kick. He's done 540 degrees, and he's waiting. And again, he's waiting on the apron. It looks like he's about to chew through the top rope to get to Adler.
This place is going to come unglued if he makes this tag. He's got a cross Numberman. He's got about 5 feet to go.
Numberman may be retreating on his own.
Now, if you're Numberman, do you tag or do you stop Adler?
You stop Adler. He didn't do it.
Uh-oh.
Sharp is charging in.
Woo! Right to the gut. Rolling elbow. No. Sharp ducks it. What in the?
Kick to the gut. Sharp has got to make the most of it.
Winners by pinfall, Jesse Adler and Smith Darrow!